in the body of Christ. Sometimes our work this week is just to plant that seed. Some of you guys are probably working in senior homes and you're painting nails or you're doing a little crafts with them. Some of them, they may not even remember that you were there. They won't even remember. A lot of the places we're going to, I relate to it because my grandmother has dementia, a little bit of Alzheimer's going on. So she kind of forgets some things for a time. One of the stories I tell about my grandma, some of you guys were on her group last year. Yeah, that was really awesome. Y'all, some of you got to see him. Sorry. But it was Christmas last year, and one of the things was we got my grandma a gift. It was like some nail files and some, like a sweater or something like that. She opens them up, and she's like, oh, man, these are awesome. She's looking at it. She's like, I can do my nails with these and all kinds of stuff like this. And so she's at her house. She lives in an assisted living place, and we take her back to her place usually later in the afternoon because she gets really tired around 6, 7 o'clock. Same, I get really tired around 6, 7 o'clock. And we pack her stuff back in that present box just like normal. And it's just like not even 5, 6 minutes later, she sees the present there. She goes, oh, is this a present for me? And opens it up with the same exact joy that she first opened up. She completely forgot that she had that present. It's kind of sad, but I also think it's very adorable with that. But sometimes our work is even just to be that light to that person within that 5 minutes. You'll go to that senior center, and you'll talk to those people. They'll tell you their life story, and then you'll come back the next day, and they won't even remember you at all or anything of what they talked about or anything like that. Another story I have, it's actually from Deep Impact. We had a casual team that went for casual. It's always our biggest week of the year. And we had a team going to a senior center. And they went to the dementia ward and the Alzheimer's ward. There's all these people there, and they all had these little baby dogs. And it was just baby dogs. They were like, look at little Michael right here. It's just this little baby dog. But they felt like this baby was real. They couldn't remember their names, but they knew that baby was real. And I tell you what, it's the most chilling thing I get goosebumps thinking about. They were sitting there listening to the people singing, because the team that went in there was singing some hymns to them, and they knew every single word to the Baptist anthem, Victory in Jesus. Mm-hmm. So they just knew every single word. And every other hymn that they sang, they knew those words. So there's just that little bit inside of them that are like, that just connects when it comes to things in the scripture. Maybe you're on a serving team and you just found out today that you were going to work at somebody's house, pressure washing a wheelchair ramp and painting a wheelchair ramp and doing some yard work. You may not get to see that owner, but you're still making an impact just by being there and being willing to take this time out of, as Jordan said, the end of your summer. I mean, school starts, y'all. Gross. I know it's hard to think about that. School starts soon. Back to homework, or you have homework, but you don't do it until that morning before, maybe in homeroom. If you guys still have homeroom, I'm guilty for that. But you have all these opportunities. Maybe you're on a construction team, and you just right now have no idea what's happening. You're like, dude, this dude with long hair just came up here and told me that I need to meet this guy named Larry at 7:30 in the morning. It's kind of this mysterious thing to this. You guys relate to that, and some of you guys are like, 7:30, you gotta meet with this guy, this is gonna be a crazy meeting. But you don't know what to expect. But the thing is, the Lord already knows what to expect. And as Jordan talked about earlier, there's these divine appointments that the Lord has already put in our place. We're not here by coincidence. Maybe you just, the bus was pulling out and you ran and jumped on the back of it, and then they stopped at a gas station. They're like, Mark, you're here. Whoa, dude, I know you're here. All right, come on, jump in. Could be why some of you guys forgot sheets. Maybe you just jumped up real quick on the bus. You forgot about that. It's okay. It happens to the best of us. But this instance with Philip and this eunuch, this Ethiopian official, I can call this a divine appointment. Philip had no idea what to expect when he came here. He had no clue. He just listened to what the Spirit said. He had no idea he was going to run into these people. And all these people, these guards around him and everything. And he just was obedient to what God told him. And through that, there was somebody who was saved. Through his obedience to the Holy Spirit. And I feel like all of you guys were obedient in some form or fashion to come here for these few days and to proclaim the gospel through building construction ramps, doing shingles on a roof, or going to a senior center or a service center, or just playing with kids. You guys were here for a reason, and I believe that there are divine appointments set up for you guys this week. And one of the things I want to challenge you guys with while we're looking at this passage is that we need to look for these divine appointments during this week, because they're everywhere. So in Luke's account of this divinely appointed encounter with the Ethiopian, would have been fascinating to the Romans. There's a couple of things with this. The Ethiopians really lived in the southern part. I don't know exactly where it is. I wasn't really good at geography at all. But it was just the southern part. It was too far away from Jerusalem. So this is a really rare occasion for this guy to be so far away from where he was supposed to be, up here near Jerusalem. Some say he was probably going to worship at the temple. He was probably going to Jerusalem at this time to worship. But God knew that this person was going to be on that road at that time. And that's why he told Philip to go. Philip would have probably never ran into this person if he wasn't obedient to the word and to what God was telling him. And so this would have been so fascinating to the Romans because they lived down here. And what we see in this passage is we see that God is actively fulfilling his purposes for the scope of the church's missions. In Acts 1:8, you start in Jerusalem, and then you expand, and then you expand some more. This would have been like, maybe not to the end of the earth, but maybe for them it felt like the end of the earth. For what they were thinking geography-wise, maybe that was the end of the earth. That last little part right there was where they needed, or was where the last people were. And so, if it reaches the Ethiopians so soon after the beginning, then Theophilus, who Luke is writing to, can know for sure that the gospel is to be, that this gospel that is being preached throughout all of the nation is true. It is for Theophilus, and it is for everybody too. It's for all of us. So as we go throughout this week, I want you guys to look for these divine appointments. You know, we always get into the thing, and you know, getting in seminary right now in seminary, everybody talks about all kinds of theological arguments that don't mean anything. We're not talking about any predestination type deal. We're not getting into any theology here. We're getting into the gospel message that God is calling us to do this week. He is calling us to go out there and to be obedient to his word and be obedient to what the Lord is saying. I want to close with a story, and I want to challenge you guys to act like this at the end of the story. But I heard the story. I was driving home. I can't remember exactly where it was, but I was driving to the house, and sometimes I like flip through the radio, and it was either a Sunday night or a Wednesday night. It must have been a Sunday night. And there's this radio preacher on. And I just, you know, sometimes just get drawn to that. I like hearing these different types of preaching. And radio preaching is really cool because it's all about the voice. You can't see them. It's all about their voice. And so I was listening to this guy. I probably couldn't even tell you who the guy was. But he told this story. He said there's this man, and his name was John. And this dude was a terrible person. I like to relate him to Barabbas, as we talked about earlier. He did all these wrong things. He was an older man. He was into a lot of alcohol, drugs, selling drugs, all kinds of things. And he would come to church every Sunday morning, but he was just really unruly in church. He was always yelling and stuff, and sometimes he had to be escorted out just because he was being so disruptive. But there was one day, he comes into church, and he is just praising the Lord. He is so excited about what is happening in his life, and he finds that joy that Jesus brings to him. He finds that salvation, and y'all, he was saved. And it was a week later, this one guy, his name is Mark, he comes into church, and he sees this guy, he's like, he's not hooping and hollering, he's praising the Lord. This is awesome. So towards the end of the service, this guy, Mark, he walks up to the front, and he gets down at the altar, and he's just in tears. He's praying, the pastor's kind of standing right there next to him, you know, as all invitations are in your church, he's just kind of standing there, looking for anybody who wants to talk. And he goes, and the guy's down around, he's in tears, and Mark is going, oh, God, please make me like John. Please make me like John, God, please. So the pastor's hearing this, and he goes down, and he touches on the shoulder, and he said, it might help if you say, please make me like Jesus. And then the astounding thing that Mark says right after that, Mark goes, is Jesus like John? Do we live in a world today where people look at you not knowing who Jesus is, and it's like, is Jesus like Sarah? Is Jesus like Jordan? Is Jesus like Melanie? Make your life be lived that where the light of Jesus shows over everything that you do. And I feel like this week is the best opportunity for you guys to be able to catch that fire and to let that show in the work that you're doing. Maybe you'll wake up tomorrow morning. I know some people are looking at 6:30 earlier and they're like, oh my gosh, 6:30 in the morning. Be thankful you don't have to do it all summer to wake up at 6:30 in the morning and get ready for breakfast at 7. But you're sitting there thinking that. But don't let the fact that you're tired hinder your witness. Because you could be sitting down on a side, kind of taking a breath, and there could be people that see you. They're like, what is this group doing here? Oh, they're just all sitting down with sad faces. I don't really feel like approaching them. Live your life almost in a way that people are like, man, is Jesus like Heath? Or if they're sitting there, insert your name there. Is this person, are you like Jesus? Are you living your life like Jesus? Does that sound good to you guys? Does that sound good to you guys? So I challenge you guys, be open to what the Holy Spirit tells you this week. The last point I kind of want to end with, and I didn't mention it earlier, but in this passage, even though Philip went up there, he was having this conversation with this eunuch, he was also ministering to those people around the eunuch. He may have not been doing it directly, but you bet me they were listening. They were probably like, what's this dude up to? And it doesn't say it in the scripture, but I believe when we get to heaven, we're going to see some of those Ethiopian guards because of Philip. Because Philip was able to plant this little seed. And Ecclesiastes has said that God has set eternity in man's heart. And I believe that the Holy Spirit is what unlocks that. Is what goes inside and fills that, and then people get it. And it makes sense. Would you guys pray with me?